This video gives a grand overview of Chapter 3, which is about cryptography. Modern public key cryptography is maybe the most significant discovery of the past 100 years. Thanks to modern crypto, we have a secure internet, and so much more. Modern crypto was very much inspired by the hard problems we have seen in the previous chapters. The first modern crypto method was, for instance, based on the knapsack problem. In our first video, we ask whether it is possible to perfectly encrypt a secret message. We discuss an unbreakable encryption scheme which is known as the one-time pad. However, this perfect security comes at a high price. Whoever wants to communicate securely first has to meet to exchange a secret key. Our second video fixes exactly that problem. We ask, can two people come up with a joint secret, even if they have never met, such that anybody who observes their entire communication does not learn the secret? This sounds truly magic. But as we show, it is indeed possible, and surprisingly simple. Whitfield Diffie and Martin Hellman discovered the algorithm about 50 years ago, and recently won a Turing Award for their discovery. We first explain the algorithm just with colors, and then we explain it using math. However, this Diffie-Hellman algorithm only works for two people. It would be a problem if we had to produce and manage a key for every pair of two people in the world. Instead, we can use public key crypto, where every person only needs one single public key and a single secret key for the whole world. Next, we discuss digital signatures. While encryption makes messages secret, digital signatures make messages safe against tampering. Digital signatures will eventually replace all handwritten signatures on transactions and contracts, since they are much more secure. Digital signatures use cryptographic hash functions. Hash functions are important in many applications, from securely storing passwords to cryptocurrencies. That's why hash functions deserve their own video. We also discuss why hash functions are related to PNNP. These last four videos use math. You might experience a deja vu when watching these videos, since all four videos are based on the discrete logarithm problem. Because of this, the math is similar in all these videos. The discrete logarithm problem is a hard problem and one popular way to set up a public key cryptosystem. Another frequently employed hard problem is integer factorization. Now you know all the important algorithms of cryptography. Our secure internet is based on these building blocks. In the next video, we discuss how these algorithms work together, and we study why you can trust your web browser to know that you are really on your bank's web page, and not some dangerous counterfeit web page. After watching all these videos, you are familiar with the key concepts of modern cryptography. Since you know much more now, the initial magic of the key exchange protocol may be gone. But the last three videos bring it right back, as we switch our focus to some more recent topics. We start with zero-knowledge proofs. In zero-knowledge proofs, one can prove to know a secret without revealing absolutely anything about the secret. We give three examples. Where is Waldo, the color-blind problem, and Hamiltonian circuits? We show to what degree these are zero-knowledge and how we can generally prove that a protocol is zero-knowledge. Next up, commitment schemes. A commitment scheme is the equivalent of a safe. You can store a secret in a safe and only reveal it when needed. Finally, we discuss the fun topic of multiparty computation. This is a general paradigm that allows the cooperation of several people that do not trust each other. Every person has an input, and we can compute a function of these inputs without revealing any input. We discuss threshold secret sharing and average salary computation. Thanks for watching this video.